Hi, it's G from Native Speakers Academy. It's odd. The temperature is going up. It should be going down. It's very bizarre. Strange things. There was an earthquake yesterday. 3.2 on the Richter scale. The epicenter was right where I live. It's very scary, apparently. There are pictures on the internet of houses with cracks in their walls. An earthquake in the middle of Slovakia. Would you believe it? Apparently there are thousands of earthquakes every day all over Europe. They're just so small that we don't feel them most of the time. Especially around the Mediterranean, where the continents of Europe and Africa are shifting. Must be shifting apart, I suppose. Although, I'm not really sure about that. Assumptions, the road to hell is paved with good assumptions. I've eaten 3 chocolate bars today. 3 chocolate bars. Now, good would be if I had eaten 0. Zero, zero. But no, I had to eat 3. I had to feed my brain with the sugar stimuli. More addictive for the brain than cocaine. Ease your pain, no one to. Always have to slow down on that little bit of road there because the police hang out around the corner. Everybody slows down. Everyone is speeding and they come to that point and they slow down and then they get past that point and they speed up. Companies that I work with is having its Christmas party tonight. It's the 5th of November. The 5th, remember, the 5th of November. Gunpowder treason and blood. There seems no reason why gunpowder treason should ever. Guy Fawkes Night, bonfire, originally bone fire, because they burned the carcasses of the animals, and I'm quite sure a few people as well on the fire. Hello, winter. Christmas, but they're having their Christmas party today, tonight, now, right now, they're having their Christmas party. It is still 2 months, effectively 2 months. You could argue it's only 7 weeks, but it's 2 months to Christmas.
Well, we can't have it closer to Christmas because there are too many other parties and too many other dates and things clash and in conflict and people have to make choices.
Yeah. So great, why the fuck don't you have it in the middle of summer?
Wait, at least be original.
Christmas, my dad. What kind of Christmas spirit can you conjure up on the 5th of November? That's just pure insanity. But if you work in that sphere, you just accept it as normal. It's normalized. They've got Christmas decorations on. Hanging out when they have a Christmas tree with the presents on. Christmas music. You're missing the point. It's because he died for our sins. And we're all in such a mess. And all you can think about is corporate gift timing, party politics. It's no accident that these organizations are called political parties. What do the executives think? Side of town, all my students came in tired as hell this week saying, oh, we have to study for more tests and more tests and more tests. What the hell are these schools doing to these kids? It looked like each kid I met this week had gone 10 rounds in a boxing ring where the other person had a baseball bat. They looked beaten down into submissive depressiveness or something. I don't even know. These are young people with life and light and energy and youth. And this is the future. This is what we're doing to the future. Dump down and overload the kids with useless, pointless bullshit that they don't need because, oh well, we don't know what you're going to need in the future, so we give you a broad spectrum of curricula that gives you an opportunity to select some of the things that might be important for you and gives you experience. No! You fucking got it all wrong! If you don't know what you're going to need in the future, there's no point trying to randomly throw things at kids and hope some of it sticks. What kind of system is that? Different than monkeys throwing poo at passing tourists hoping that one of them is going to take a picture. Yes, some sick people like it, but teachers, what are you doing? I have to give my kids. School plus kids equals skids. Yay. Oh dear. Right. I have to give my kids motivational lectures so that they get their homework done. And the motivational lectures are basically, don't let the bastards grind you down. Because if they grind you down and you run out of energy, then they've won. They've got you. They've trapped you.
Set them free. Trust. Poor kids are so tired. I remember coming home from school and lighting a fire and falling asleep in front of the fire because I didn't have the energy to do anything else. Or sometimes lying down in bed and just falling asleep in bed. And my mother would wake me up when she got home. We are the energy of tomorrow. Really? The reason I got this far has got nothing to do with school and fuck all to do with any motivation or rubbish that I didn't get from my family. It's all about you. Down has begun. What are you waiting for? The right time does not exist. There is no such thing as the right time. There is only where you are and what you do. Those who have built successful worlds. Say it again, burn through every day like a supernova, like you're on fire, like a meteor bursting through space. Let people know that you're on a mission. Let them know to get out of your way. Without it's hard. I met a lot of people in May today. A lot of people. And I tried to make their days a little bit easier. It's all we can do sometimes, apply a little bit of comfort. Help each other along. Help each other to get further down the road. Because it's a long road. And it's a never-ending fight. The moment you think you've got where you want to be, about the quality of the day. I just saw my friend, he was walking down the road. I'm going to go back and see if he needs a lift. I reckon he's missed the bus and he has to walk down the road.